बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अप टू द एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू क्राइटेरिया। एक्सपेक्टेड मीन्स समथिंग इन विच समहाउ द प्रोबेबिलिटी विल बी इनकॉर्पोरेटेड। एज इन द एग्जाम्पल यू कैन सी द रेस्ट ऑफ द These part are the same as the since the start of the lecture. Mean the table, the payoff, where the five state of the nature. Moreover, we have the four alternative. About the expected value criteria, we were given some probability. In the last column, we were given some probability. What we need to in order to compute the probability, these probability will be multiplied by the corresponding payoff. These are the corresponding payoff. Make a summation. For example, make a summation. Then what will be the output is we will compute the expected value. We'll have a column with the expected value for all of the alternatives. We found the summation is equal to 100, 130, 125, and 160. Once we computed the expected value column and find the all of the values, the maximum value should be the optimal decision. So the optimal decision is optimally corresponding to maximum value 130 is equal to investment in the company A. So we have done this in the previous lecture. Now, for example, here it create a variable expected value. Expected return of the expected value EREV. What is EREV? It is the return of the expected value. It is a well, how do we compute return of the maximum value? For example, here 100, 130, 125, 60, 100, 130, 125, 60, and the maximum value is 130. This will be the EREV, expected return of the expected value. One more. Now let's talk about the yes, please note it that this. Noted that these are the word. This will be used in the next. This line will be used in the next. Okay. Now let's talk about the expect more discuss about expected value criteria. The expected value criteria is used generally in the case where the decision maker is risk neutral. Recall that in the first category that are the decision making under uncertainty, and a subcategory of the something about the neither pessimistic nor optimistic. Similar to the feature, they have the same feature. Yeah, the decision does not correlate with the behavior of the decision maker. So in other words, because if the risk neutral, then this criteria is very useful. This criteria does not take into account the decision maker attitude toward the possible losses, whereas in the first category, that decision making under uncertainty, the decision somehow correlate with the behavior of the decision maker. For this, the behavior include about the pessimistic, optimistic, etc. We will see the utility theory offer an alternative or to the expected value criterion. Later on, we will discuss another important concept as the utility theory, in which we not only include about the probability, but also include about the behavior of the decision maker. That is the combination of the uncertainty and the combination of the probability. Somehow we will incorporate in a utility theory. So we will see later on when this concept will come. But just know that in the utility theory we will consider both aspects features. Now let's talk about the expected opportunity loss. Suppose a table will be given as this is the table of payoff will be given to us. Three state of the nature and three alternative A, B, C. Three or state of the nature either increase the share, decrease the share, loss of the share, and they remain the same. What we need to do? How do we compute this category for the expected opportunity loss? First, we will compute what is the maximum value for each of these state of the nature. Then the rest of the payoff value will be subtracted from the maximum value. So 80 minus 80 is equal to 0. Then 80 minus 10 is equal to 70. 80 minus 10 equal to 70. Then first we will compute expected loss table. Okay, these are the expected loss table. These probability were also given to us. Then what is the maximum value here? 70. 70 minus 10 60. 70 minus 70 is 0. 70 minus 20 is 15. And the probability is equal to 0.3. What is the maximum value? 70. 70 minus 10 60. 50 is 0. Third step is once we created the expected loss table, then we will find out the expected value. How do we compute the expected value? The probability multiplied by the value for the expected table and make a summation for all of the alternative. 0.4 multiplied by 0. Let me change the color so that it will be more clear to you. 0.4 multiplied by 0, then 0.3 multiplied by 60, then 0.3 multiplied by 60, make a sum equal to 36. In the similar way, for example, for the second alternative, it is equal to 43. Now we need to find which one is the minimum value because it is the opportunity loss. We found the minimum value is 36. It means since the expected opportunity loss is equal to minimum expected opportunity is equal to 36, then what is the optimal decision? Optimal decision is investment in the alternate A. So this is the optimal decision. Decision A is the optimal decision. So again, you can see, for example, the expected opportunity loss, the concept, the steps, they are very, very similar in the regret, in the maximum regret criteria, in the uncertainty decision making. We just need to multiply or incorporate the probabilities. The rest of the steps, they are the same. Now let's talk about the expected value of the perfect information. This is the expected value of the perfect information. What is this? Let's see. Expected value of the perfect information include about the gain in the expected return obtained. It means the gain. Gain means, what is the concept for the gain? Gain is something about the difference between them. Later on the next slide, I will show you how do we compute the difference. It is a gain. Some gain for the IP, it will be the gain. Expected value of the perfect information will be computed, expected return of the expected information, and expected the gain, the expected return obtained from the knowing with certainty the future state of the nature is called the expected value of the perfect information. Let in the next slide we will solve numerical so that it will be more clear to you how do we compute the EVPI expected value of the perfect information. Here, what is the expected of these part of the table, they are the same. Okay, I will change the color so that it is more clear to you. So here, this part is the same. We have four alternative and five state of the nature, and these are their payoff. These are the same as we are discussing throughout the chapter. Okay, then what we need to do right now, a probability will also be given to us. These are the probability will be given to us. Okay, what we need to compute. Okay, the table are the same, but it include about the payoff value along with the corresponding probabilities. What we need to compute, EVPI expect value of the perfect information, and it is equal to the expected return of the perfect information minus expected return of the expected value. Okay, let me first discuss how do we compute these two values so that we can find the difference or the gain. So first we need to find for all of the state of nature, what is the maximum value for this. For the first one, what is the maximum value? This is the maximum value. Here we can see as highlighted with the box, with the blue box, these are the maximum value. So if we know with the certainty that the market is going to large rise, if the market is going to large rise, then on the other hand, if the market has a large fall, then the optimal decision should be investment. So if the market is large, then the optimal decision will be investment company. On the other hand, if the market should have small rise, again make the investment in the company B. If the market is will be no changes, then make the investment in gold. If the market again have the small fall over the interval of year, then we need to investment in the gold. Then if the market have a large fall, then make the investment in company C. As it is written here, small fall, the optimal decision should be company. For the small fall, make the investment in gold, make the investment in gold. This is one of the features. Then we need to compete about the expected return with the preferred information. ERPI, expected return of the preferred information. Then how do we compute the expected return of the preferred information? Just make a summation of the probability, multiply by corresponding maximum value, make a summation. So it in other words, we can say here 0.2 multiply by 500, 0.2 multiply by 500, because 500 is the maximum value for this state of the nature or the large rise. Second, 0.3 multiply by 250, 0.3 multiply by 250, then 0.3 multiply by 200, 0.2, 0.3 multiply by 200, then 0.1 multiply by 300, 0.1 multiply by 300, 0.1 multiply by 60, 0.1. Make a summation, it is equal to 271, or in other words, ERPI is equal to 271. So ERPI, which is computed, is equal to 1271. What about the expected return of the expected value? We have calculated in the slide. How do we compute? We have computed the ERAV. In the previous slide, we talk about the expected value. Expected return of the expected value is equal to maximum for the expected value. So it is equal to 130. In the previous slide, we have computed EREV is equal to 130. So we will use this value, EREV, which is equal to 130, as we have calculated the previous. The difference is equal to 141. This is the difference for the 141. Moreover, this is another method in this slide. We have another method. How do we compute this value? How do 141 can also be computed? Another method. So as we saw, if the first we need to know if Ahmed knew in advance the market will going to be undergo it the for the over the year the market will large rise, small rise, no change, small change, large change, then what is the market behavior? Come back to the previous slide. If the market is large rise, for example, for large rise, Ahmed will invest in company B. For the small value, small rise, invest in company B also. Then for the gold, investment in the for the no change, investment in sector. As you can see here, each of the state of the nature, this is the market behavior. As we see in the previous slide, we have the highest value for the highest value among the state of the nature. So company B, gold, company C. Then how do we compute this? Now let's discuss about how do we compute. Miss, note here, this is another method. How do we get 141? As we see, you can see this is we get another method. So come back. First, we need to know what is the maximum value. These are the maximum value: 500, 250, 200, 300, 600. Come back. 500, 250, 200. 360 means for each of the state of the nature, the maximum value we will put here. Then now we need to know how do we get these values. 250, 200 means these are the values what we got from the EREV. In the EREV, expected return of the expected value. Then what is the maximum? Here, these are the values: 250, 200, 150, माइनस 100, माइनस 150, सो नोट इट इज वैल्यू 250, 200, 150 माइनस 100, 250, 200, माइनस 1, माइनस 100, सो दीज आर द वैल्यूज. देन व्हाट वी गेट द डिफरेंसेस, दीज डिफरेंसेस मल्टीप्लाई बाय द कोरस्पोंडिंग प्रोबेबिलिटी. 250 मल्टीप्लाई बाय प्रोबेबिलिटी फॉर ईच ऑफ द सेट ऑफ द नेचर, तो दीज आर द प्रोबेबिलिटी 0.2, 0.3, 0.3, 0.1, 0.1, these are the probability for state of the nature multiplied by the correspondence we find is equal to 141. So this is another method we can compute to for expected value of the perfect information. The previous method, both of these methods they have created, either you can use this method or you can use this method. You can compute, for example, first you compute the ERPI. How do we compute ERPI? The maximum value. ERPI with the maximum value, okay, corresponding to the probability minus EAV. How do we compute the ERAV? As we saw in the previous slide, these are how do we compute the ER. First, we compute the expected value, then find the maximum value. This is how do we compute the. So, this is the. Now, let's talk about the another important concept, decision making with imperfect information. We want to make a decision, but our information is not 100% correct, or there is a very little bit information, a very little bit information. It is normally we call this the imperfect information. Let's discuss what are the features. Some statistical scientists research argue that it is unnecessary to predict decision making under uncertainty. Means they mention that in the uncertainty, the decision making under uncertainty, we do not have any concept for the probability. Then researchers told that it is unnecessary to make a decision with uncertainty, because one always has at least some probability into related to the state of the region. He told that how minimum the information is, but at least we have a little bit information about the probability of the state of the nature. Then if somehow you get the probability instead of the nature, then recommended to use this additional information. Bayesian statistics play a role in assessing additional information obtained from the various sources. How do we get this additional information? This additional information, for example, we can get from the financial institution, from the counseling companies, or from the research market. Because they always keep their eye on the market value. So it is suggested that we can get a little information. Might be it is not that we then somehow we will incorporate this additional information. They use the additional information. Noted that. Obtained from the various sources. So then how this additional information can be incorporated? This additional information message in refining the original probability estimate and help improve the making decision. Means somehow it will improve the original probability. It means it is that although the additional information is also in the form of probability. So whereas it will improve or refine our original probability. It means we have two types of probability. One type of the probability is about the previous probability. The second type of the probability is something additional information form, which is what we call the posterior probability. So we will discuss how this additional information can be incorporated. Before we started, first we need about the Bayes' theorem. Okay, you are not required to, for example, you are not required to know how this Bayes theorem was created, but we only need to know about how this theorem will be applied for the additional information to incorporate to the previous probability. Let's see what is the probability. This theory was proposed in 1763. It means more than 200 years ago. Or 250 years ago, this theory was presented by Bayes' theorem. Theorem Bayes, an essay toward solving the problem in the doctrine of chances or probability. these are the name of the paper in which they present this his concept. Philosophical Transaction of the Royal Society of London, page number from page number 370 to 418 and volume number 53. Now come back, what are the theorems? These theorems stated the probability of A such that B has occurred can be, it is equal to the probability of B such that A has occurred multiplied by the probability of A divided by the probability of B. On the other hand, if you make a cross multiplication, they are equal as the probability of B multiplied by, let me clear this one. If you call cross multiplication here, then probability of B multiplied by A such that A B has occurred, or A upon B is equal to B upon A multiplied by A. Whatever do we have in the denominator or the conditional, if we will multiply the corresponding probability, then it is equal, then A over B and B over A somehow make them equivalent. Or so then how do we compute this, the probability of A over B? For example, here how do we compute A over B? A over B is equal to the probability of A and B. We will compute the probability of A and B divided by the probability of B. Here, divide by the probability of B. Then, yes, as we saw, how about B over A? Again, B over A, if A over B, here it is B over B. Here, in which they have part divided by T. If for the B over A, again the same is, the probability of B and A divided by probability of B. Since these two probabilities are equal, so if we multiply by this one and multiply by this one, these two will also be equal. So in other words, we can say the probability of A over B multiplied by the probability of B is equal to probability of B over A multiplied by B over A. So in other words, if these two parts, they are equal, as a thing, this is equal, then we can prove, we can cross multiplication with here, and the cross multiplication with this, these two are equal, then this also is equal. So in other words, we can say probability of A and B is equal to probability of B over A. For example, here, the probability of A and B, this is this part, multiplied by corresponding this part. And one equation, the equation number one told that the probability of A, the A and B is equal to probability of B over A, the probability of B over A, as is computed, the part, this part is computed here. Okay, divide by me. So we not go into the detail how the Thomas Bayes created this theorem. We will focus on the how do we use these concepts. Let's see. What is the basic theorem? How do we incorporate? Often we were given the probability analysis with the initial or period probability. Often we started for any analysis, we were given some probability. We have known as, for example, because there are two types of probabilities were involved, how can we make differentiate between them? We can differentiate that we have the probability before some additional information, and we have the probability after some additional information. Before the additional information, we can have the period probability. Yeah, period probability. So initial probability or the period probability. Then from a sample, special report, then later on, so we get the sample, somehow we have some additional information, somehow then we will incorporate as yes. or some product test, we have some additional information, get this information, obtain some somehow, it means we somehow we get the information from the report, from the survey, from the product sample, from the testing somewhere. Then given the information, because we have this additional information, what we will do, we will revise our probability or the posterior probability because of the additional information. Bayes theorem provide a mechanism how this revising prior probability will occur, means how the additional information and will be incorporated to the paperwork. It means starting with the paperability, somehow we will get some additional information. These additional information some in the form of weak as a probability. Then we will apply the Bayes' theorem. Then once you apply the Bayes' theorem, we will get the posterior probability. Means posterior means after revising the probability, what we get the posterior probability. More concept are our the Bayes' theorem as knowledge of the sample survey. Knowledge sample survey information can be used to revise the probability estimate for the state of the nation. Means sometime we get the survey product testing of the product. Some financial institute they give this information. Some prediction from the some estimation from the for example that the news from the government sources that they may revise, they may have some new change in the regulation. So this will be, so these are the additional information. Prior to applying the information, the probability is called the peer probability. Before getting the information, additional information, that we call the peer probability. These are the same as we saw, just the more description for the peer probability, posterior probability. Otherwise, these are the concepts which we have already discussed in the previous slide. Then, with the knowledge of conditional probability, we get the additional knowledge with the conditional probability. Then, the indicator of the sample of the survey, these peer probability will be revised by employing the Bayes' theorem, because we want to incorporate the additional information, then we require some mechanism. Bayes' theorem provide a mechanism that additional information will be included or integrated with the peer probability. What will be the outcome? The outcome is called the posterior probability or the branch probability for the decision. It will be more clear when we solve the numerical. Let's see. For example, here what they represent: A1, A2, A3, A4, An, they are the mutually exclusive and collectively exhaustive. So these are the, so in a starting with the, so we can say what is the we have as we events are A1, A2, A3 are mutually exclusive and collectively exhaustive. What is mutually exclusive means only one state of the nature will occur. This is mutually exclusive. Collectively exhaustive, collectively exhaustive means total make up everything that can possibly will be happen for the experiment, for the event. So this AI represent the, this AI represent the A1, A2, A3, An. Then how do we compute this one? That is the posterior probabilities. These posterior probabilities probably determined after adding additional information become available. How do we compute the posterior probability? We will compute applying the Bayes' theorem is probability of B. Here they apply the concept A/B, B/A. As we saw, we talk about the A/B, B/A. We will apply here. We are trying to apply these concepts here. A/B and B/A. Then let's see. For example, here how do we compute? What is this is the interpretation of the probability of B such that A1 will occur multiplied by the corresponding probability of A. A1 is, these are the pre-probability. A1, A2, A3, A4, An, they are the pre-probability. Probability estimate determined based before the current information, based on the current information, before the new information become available. Before the new information are available. Then it will be more clear when we are solving the numerical. Let's see. Example is how do we incorporate the additional information? Ahmed can purchase ignominy forecast result for the 50 year. It means, recall that in the start of this chapter we talk about Ahmed somehow have 1000 riyal. He want to make the investment of 1000 riyal so that he can have some in the profit. But because what sometime Ahmed got some additional information, obviously he need to pay some money to get this additional information. Maybe this additional information it will be given by some financial companies. Obviously they will not give you this additional information free of charge. They will charge you some money. Now you need to check either after getting this additional information, more or after making some of the payment, still you have some profit or not? This is what is our question. Means additional information can give you some more profit or not. So that's why before making the investment, big companies, they ask the consultant, financial companies about their report. Yes. Let's see. Ahmed can basically the forecast predict negative and the positive economic growth. Regarding this one, that this forecast, okay, have something about the this is the forecast in which we get information in the form of some economic growth, economical growth in terms of positive and negative probabilities, positive growth and the negative growth. The statistics regarding forecast are, so it is the forecast predicted positive economic growth and for the negative economic growth as it is mentioned here. Additional information in the form of positive and negative. So again, for the same state of the nature, that is small rise, large rise, no change, small fall, large fall, the same state of the nature, we get this additional information in the form of positive economic growth, negative economic growth in terms of percentage, 80%, 70%, 50%, 40%, 0%. Or in other words, these percentages can also be converted into the probability as 0.8, 0.7, 0.5, 0.40. As you are familiar with, for example, someone get 6 out of 10, it means he got 0.6, 0.6 represents 60%. Here they mentioned these values in the form of percentage. Otherwise, then what is the interpretation of this one? What does it mean here? Here, when the company B is recalled in the previous slide, for the large rise, we will follow for the investor probably make the investment in the company B. So when the company B shows the large rise, the forecast predicted a positive growth of 18% at the time. So in other words, this is the interpretation. When the company B, as we saw, large rise feature for the company B, then it will show the progress for the 80% growth in the positive growth. Or in other words, we can say it shows the 20% for the negative growth. 20% for the negative growth. One more thing noted here. The sum of positive growth and negative growth, both the combination, the summation is equal to 1. All of them 1. These are all of them. They are the summation of positive and negative growth should be 1. Then interpretation is P. Probability of forecast predicted positive for the positive. Okay, for the small rise in the market, for the small rise, this state of the nature will be used is equal to 0.7 or 70%. Or in the other one, the probability of the forecast predicted negative for the negative small rise in the market is equal to 0.3. Or let me do one more example with you with this one. The probability of the forecast predicted positive for the small fall for the in the market is equal to 0.4. The probability for the forecast predicted negative for the small fall, these are the small fall, it will be equal to 0.6. So now the question is, Ahmed, should Ahmed purchase this forecast or not? Means because if he will purchase, he need to give the price for 50 riyal. If he will not purchase, somehow and make his own decision, maybe he will save these 50 riyal. We need to make the analysis either Ahmed should purchase or should not purchase. To find the expected payoff with the Ahmed, with the forecast, Ahmed should determine what to do. So it means for the expected payoff with the additional information, what we need to find the forecast for the positive growth, forecast for the negative growth. So what we need to do for each of the state of the nature, that is for small rise, large rise, no change, small change, small fall, large fall, for each of the state of the nature, we incorporate this one, that is the probability of large rise such that the forecast predicted positive. The same exercise will also be done for the for the negative also. It means in the previous slide we talk about the positive economic growth and the negative economic growth. So these positive and negative economic growth will be incorporated for each of the state of the nature. So Bayes' theorem apply the mechanism. How can we incorporate this information? Let's see what they do in the tabular form. For example, here recall that what are the values do we have? Point, for example, 0.8, 0.7, 0.5, 0.4, 0. 80% for the 0.8, 0.7, 0.5, 0.4, 0. So what will we incorporate these values as? 0.8, 0.7, 0.5, 0.40, or this is the probability for the positive. These are the probabilities for the positive economic growth for each of the state of the nature. These are the five state of the nature. These are some probability as we before getting this actual information. First step is we will compute the joint probability. How do we compute the joint probability? Just make the multiplication. 0.2 multiplied by 0.1 is equal to 0.16. So in this way, we will compute the joint probability. Or what is the interpretation is 0.1 is it is the AI which is the large rise. It belongs to the share of the nature large rise, and B is the forecast positive. These are the forecast for the positive. It can be computed probability of these are the probability B such that A is an occurred multiplied by the probability of A1. This is the okay. Then these are the probability for this that A is an occurred multiplied by the probability. Solving for this one, we get the joint probability. These are the joint probability for the positive. We also compute the joint probability for the negative also. Let's see. Okay, here this column number one, the period probability were given to us. Second one is about the these are the some probability additional information in the form of positive economic growth and negative economic growth as we saw in the previous slide. Then we compute the joint probability. How do we compute the joint probability? Just make the multiplication of this one joint probability. This is until this now we have computed in the previous slide. What we need to do? First, make a summation of this one. The summation of the joint probability is equal to 0.56. Once you identify the, once you find out the sum of the probability, then we will compute the posterior probability. What is posterior probability? Posterior probability is equal to the 0.16, that these are the joint probability, divided by the total. 0.16 divided by the total. Then how do we compute 0.375? It is equal to joint probability 0.21 divided by the total. In this way, we will compute the posterior probability, or in other words, mean additional information is incorporated, and these are our revised probability, revision of the state of the nature. This is revision of the state of the nature. So here what they mention about the how do we compute 0.56. Since we have computed the positive economic growth, the same experiment or exercise or the process will be performed for the negative economic growth, negative forecast. So that these are the for these are the peer probability, they are the same as we saw in the previous slide, they are the same. But we have the for probability for the negative economic growth. Again, we will compute the joint probability, just make the multiplication for them. Then we will compute what is the summation. Once we get summation, then each of the joint probability will be divided by the summation and find the posterior probabilities. Same exercise as we saw in the previous slide. Then here, for example, in the next slide, it shows about a table. Here, for example, what are the state of the nature? For example, here, number example, five state of the nature. Large rise, small rise, no change, small fall, large fall. Okay, these are the period probability that will be given to us. Then some conditional probability, or that we can say conditional probability or probability for the positive economic growth will be given. Somehow we get this information. Then how we will compute the joint probability? How do we compute joint probability? Just make the multiplication. Once you find joint probability, then we will make a summation. Then we can find the posterior probability for the positive. How to compute joint probability divided by total? This is how do we compute this is for the positive and this for the negative. What I mean to say, although for example, right now we have the five state of the nature. We need to do a lot of calculation for each of the state of the nature. A lot of calculation is required. But the point is here, these software companies, they have the build up, already built up software they are available. Just need to enter the values and the report will be generated. Automatically report will be generated. So even for our use, for example, we can create an Excel sheet. All of these steps they were given to us. We can create the Excel sheet and we can get the result. So what we make the calculation in the previous slide, enter the calculation. Not only for this type, for example, for the EVPI or expected value of the expected return, expected value of the perfect information, or expected value of the sample information, automatically they will calculate. It means within few minutes we can get the result. Right now we were given only 5 instead of the nature. Even we have the 100 instead of the nature, we can easily get. So now what we need to do, expected value of this, I will stop here, for example, because this concept required a little bit sequence will be required. So what we are trying to do, we want to compute the expected value of the sample information. It means expected value of the sample information, somehow we purchase or get additional information. We need to compute either it will be beneficial or not beneficial. So one of the terminologies used about EVSI, expected value of the sample information. It is the gain from the making the decision based on the sample information. Revise the expected return of the first of the decision using the posterior probability. Means using the posterior probability, it will revise our prior probability. So we need to compute EVSI, expected return of sample information. Previously, we talked also about the expected value of the perfect information. Right now, we are doing expected value of the sample information. So let me show you one thing, then I will stop. These are some of the formula. How expected value of the perfect information, how do we calculate ERPI, then EREV. EREV, compute the maximum for the expected value. ERPI, maximum with each of the state of the nature. Multiply corresponding probability, make a summation. Then here we got EVSI, again the same. Here, both of them, they will be subtracted. These EREV will be subtracted. Then we can easily compute the efficiency. Efficiency is equal to EVSI, this one, divided by EVPI, this one. Okay, we will stop right now. One more thing about, inshallah, today we will have, today inshallah, we will have at 5 o'clock the online quiz number 1. I will make a request to you that read the guidelines. What are the guidelines for them? Since you are allowed to have 2 login attempt. So why these 2 login attempt are given to you? So that you can avoid any network failure or the computer hang. So if you told the doctor, my network was hanged, my network is not working, or there's problem. So that's why you were given 2 login attempts. So please make sure that you have some stable connection or stable computer and laptop. Secondly, about the, do not try to go back to the previous question. Okay, if you try to back the previous question, maybe you will lose your time. Do not try to copy and paste the URL to the new window, something, or copy the URL to the new window, or you want to see the answer before the exam finish. Do not, otherwise you may lose your attempt. Then you will tell me, doctor, I was go to the previous question, something has, or my or then something I have refreshed something. So maybe you will lose your answer. So this is why I'm emphasizing this one. I'm emphasizing because a student, if they do this practice LMS software, the software which will contributed towards the LMS multiple choice and true and false, then it will treat it as a something unlawful, something you will lose your time. So just even for example, if you have some problem with logarithm, you can choose your second attempt. That's why you are given two logarithms. So otherwise, if you do something beyond this one, then you can, then I cannot do anything. Okay, so thanks of you. Thank you very much. If you, now you may leave the session.